the most about DGS is coming each year and going into my classes and meeting new people, because there was always someone that you hadn't met in your senior class that, you know, you could meet and find out about.
I think my most embarrassing moment is when I dressed up as Dennis Rodman for Halloween. It was a lot of fun, but after I looked at the pictures and, like, towards the end of the day, having on leather pants and, like, a feather boa and makeup and a leopard shirt that was pretty tight, it was kind of embarrassing.
Ready to leave would be a good way to describe the senior class. I would have to say my most embarrassing moment is about 3 weeks ago, I rear-ended this guy. I hit his car from the back, right in front of the school. I guess that would count as one of my most embarrassing moments.
Embarrassing moment had to have been freshman year when I walked into the women's teachers' lounge and saw a couple teachers in there. I don't think I should have.
Your most favorite teacher and why?
Favorite? I'd have to say Mrs. Van Zandt, because she's down to earth and she helps people figure out who they are as opposed to how they want to be molded.
Mrs. Krause, my work program teacher.
And you?
Say Mr. Wiggins.
So John, do you run track here?
Yeah, I got conference meet today.
Oh, you got conference meet today. So how long have you been running track?
Since eighth grade.
Eighth grade, so you're pretty fast, huh?
I'm the best.
Oh, he's the best. Chuck, are you a little thirsty today?
Yes, I am. Tired.
You know, Chuck was our big soccer star here at DGS. Chuck, where are you going to school next year?
Southwest Missouri State, Springfield, Missouri.
Oh, yeah? You got any special talents, Alex?
Good at basketball.
You good at basketball?
Yeah.
Good at leaving school for a little bit and then coming back?
No.
No.
How do you know about that?
I don't know anything about it. Look at his little eyes crinkle up. You see that?
Brian, this is senior video. Do you have anything to say to the senior class?
Yeah, I want to sleep, please.
Now, with the hot weather outside,
yes.
Does it feel any different being in school, or do you just want to get the heck out?
I really don't want to be here. Pepsi, choice of a new generation.
Yeah, sure. Doing anything special for spring break?
Yeah, I'm going to Minnesota, where I would do a lot of shopping.
Shopping for what?
For clothing.
You are in Madrigals, are you not?
Yeah.
So that means you're a pretty good singer, are you not?
I suppose you could say that.
So I can assume that you will sing for us right now.
Okay. I suppose I could, what is that?
I don't know, I'm trying to start you off. Come on, Kurt. A good voice.
I know I have a good voice. It's just, you know, I don't really do these impromptu performances.
Not even for the senior video, Kurt. For history, for posterity, for your kids.
For my kids, I don't think they're going to be watching this.
This is Amy Cato. She's single-handedly taken on the adventure of trying to collect 1 million Pop-Tops in this school. So, Amy, tell us a little about this.
Well, it's going well. We're hoping to get 1 million Pop-Tops, but we're not sure about that. But as you can see, we collect them on our containers. Very cool.
Just out of curiosity, how many Pop-Tops do we have?
We're about at 500,000 right now.
Okay. Do you think you'll get 500,000 in another 2 months?
We hope so. We have some unique plans to get people collecting, so we'll see what happens.
Gifts and money?
That would be nice. Want to donate some?
No.
Are you going anywhere for spring break, Nisha?
No, I will be at home with my boyfriend. I have no life, so I will be at home.
Anything you'd like to say to the seniors next year?
Learn how to jig.
So, do you have anything to say to the senior class this year?
Have a good time in school next year. That's it.
Read it to us.
Yes, I'm going
to
read something from poetry. In a knot of eight crossings, which is about the average size knot, there are 256 different over and under arrangements possible. Make only one change in this over and under,
sequence and either entirely different knot is made or no knot at all may result.
Now, was that your best poetry voice?
So where do you see yourself in 10 years, Jay?
Probably happy, maybe lying out, passed out on a beach somewhere.
How many Tom Cruise movies do you own, Lauren?
I don't know.
Take a guess.
All of them.
Hi, Christy. How are you?
Hi.
Did I just see that you came in late and it is 8:40?
I have late arrival.
Late arrival.
I've only got 2 classes, remember?
That's the excuse everyone uses.
Thanks, Sanjay.
So why exactly are you late?
I have 2 classes, Sanjay.
You're not just joking, are you?
No, I have 2 classes.
Okay. So with such a tardy appearance of you, what do you think you're going to be doing in 10 years?
Running the world. I'm going to be president.
You're going to be president?
I'm going to be president, and I'm going to come in every single day late, Sanjay.
Okay. My fondest memory of DGS would probably just be all the teachers that I had throughout my 4 years, the people that I met, and just everything I've learned throughout the 4 years.
My fondest memory of DGS would have to be a 3-way tie between making a final catch versus Waubonsie Valley in the opening round for the opening game of the season, hitting a 3-point shot to put a playoff game in overtime versus Brother Rice, and all the laughing attacks that I've had over the years.
My fondest memory would have to be winning state for Phillies. It was really exciting, and we worked really hard for it, and we got it. It was last year.
My fondest memory of DGS will probably hanging out in the library, the computer lab, trying to ditch study hall. Walking around, my fondest memory is also a lot of the teachers, a lot of the great teachers I had, Mr. Wright, Mrs. Cedarblad, also Mr. Kreider, just a lot of the people in down in Grove South.
So what do you do here exactly?
Oh, I monitor the attendance in 6 study halls, and I supervise all the detentions.
Oh my gosh, you supervise all the detentions? They get pretty wild, don't they?
No, they're pretty calm because they don't want to be confronted with referrals and facing the deans any more than they have to.
You think you're pretty intimidating?
Probably, because I have an old grouchy look most of the time.
Do you enjoy this class?
Yes.
Are you getting extremely fit? And,
yes, very fit.
Athletically toned?
Very.
Could you show us your muscles?
Sure.
Wow, look at that.
We gotcha. Hi, Serena.
Hello. Hi, Sarah. What's up?
Not much. How you doing?
Fine. What's this for?
Senior video.
Hi, how you doing?
So, Serena.
Hey.
How do you love DGS?
I wouldn't call it love.
At this moment in time, what's your national merit status?
My national merit status is finalist.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
So can you elaborate on that a little more?
Sure. I'm a finalist.
You know, Sue, I remember way back in sophomore year, we had Mr. Dodd together. Do you remember Mr. Dodd?
Late. Yes.
Yeah, we were always late. So if you
came in 30 minutes late. Didn't even go to class.
Yeah, we both did it. So are you still late all the time?
No.
I am.
I didn't know if you noticed, but you have a piece of metal in your eyebrow.
Oh, yeah. I need this because... Yeah, I need to graduate in school, the Downers Grove South, I forgot. Yeah, the gym policy won't let me use hoops.
Thank you! Lisa, you got anything to say to the senior class?
Class 98 is the bomb!
Oh. So where do you think you'll be in about 10 years?
Modeling.
Modeling, wow! Oh my gosh! Well, can you show the camera how you do some modeling?
Oh, come on,
don't be shy.
What do you want me to do?
Put your bag down, do a little modeling for the camera. Woo, yeah!
Hello, how are you doing?
I'm fine.
And your name is?
My name's Adam, sitting in rock and jazz class.
So how do you like this class, Adam?
Oh, Mr. Eros is the best teacher in the whole school. I love you.
Joe was our star wrestler this year. Tell us how wrestling went.
Martine was better.
But how were you?
I was all right.
You were all right? Did you have a good season?
Yeah, I had a pretty good season.
Hey, Sammy, so how'd gymnastics go this year?
It went okay. I went to state this year for beam. I was pretty happy with it, so.
How'd you do?
I don't know how I finished on beam. I did. Okay, I think I placed like 14th or something, so.
Oh, that's cool. So the talent show's coming up. Are you excited?
Yeah, I can't wait to do it. Me and my sister are doing rhythmic gymnastics and a little tumbling and stuff, so it should be fun.
It's okay. And where are you guys going to be attending school next year?
West Point Military Academy.
Iowa State University.
Sounds good. You have all your college clothes picked out? College jerseys and sweatshirts and stuff?
Not yet.
Hi.
Can we ask where you got that flower from?
This is conference track we have today.
Okay, how's track gone this year so far?
It's gone good so far. Hopefully we'll win.
Okay, what was your favorite meet and which one did you do the best at?
Hopefully this will be our favorite meet and we'll do the best at this one.
Hi, Mrs. Caso, how are you today?
Okay.
I'd like to wish you a happy 40th birthday.
Thank you very much.
What do you think about the senior class this year?
Oh, they're great.
So listen up, Brett. So where do you see yourself in about 10 years?
10 years? On the street collecting change, maybe.
Now, Katie, you're a pretty good dancer, I hear.
Not really.
How long have you been dancing?
About 12 years.
About 12 years. Well, then you should be able to dance for the senior video. Katie, don't be shy. You are the, like, Captain Philly, okay? Come on.
5, 6, 7, 8.
So, Ms. O'Brien, what exactly do you do here at TGS?
Well, I'm a driver's ed teacher, and presently I'm taking over for Ms. Lazzaroni's classes because she had her baby girl.
What's the baby girl's name?
Kendall Ann Cavanaugh.
That sounds so Irish.
Yeah, I'm born on St. Patrick's Day, but, you know, normally I'm teaching driver's ed, but I'm teaching PE for the next quarter, so
So how long have you been coaching basketball, Ms. O'Brien?
Oh, yeah, I'm also a coach. Thanks. 8 years here.
Could you shoot a basket for us? Thanks. No pressure. Just go for it. Woo! Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
So you guys going to be going to prom tomorrow?
Most definitely.
Most definitely. All right. You going to be wearing your gym uniforms?
I want to, but then y'all told me not to wear it.
Okay. Okay. Well, if you do, you know, I'm behind you all the way.
I am. So I won't feel like a fool if I go in there with my, you know.
They're very comfortable.
And it's the style now. You know, they're our colors.
So we have to change everything. We have to show our school spirit, you know, how much we love DGS, you know?
That's right.
What class is this, Tony?
Rock and jazz.
Rock and jazz. Is this your favorite class?
It's okay.
It's all right. You know, I hear you're a pretty good dancer.
Yes, I am.
Can you show us how you dance? All right, thank you. Slot. Tear for Tony, come on.
Papa may have, but God bless the child. That's God his own. That's God his own. Them that's God their own.
Well, some of my fondest memories of DGS are probably basketball and football games. Me and my friends had a blast at them this year, and of course the dances. Used to make signs and everything. It was a lot of fun.
I'll probably miss all the people I've met that I know I'm not going to keep in touch with after I leave, but I'm going to miss all of them probably the most.
My most embarrassing moment was falling down the stairs, actually. Coming down the stairs by, was it, 8th period, trying to hurry up and get the bus, and my friend tripped me down the stairs, really. So.
The senior class, in one sentence, I think would have to be, actually I could put it into one word, eccentric. Everyone's different. There's not one person that's alike anyone else. I think everybody has their own traits that are unique.
Miss the most about Downers Grove South. Probably our trailer park out there with our PCs. I've always enjoyed going out there in the air conditioning and being able to walk outside. So.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. But in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
So do you go to Burger King every morning?
Every other morning.
Every other morning. So what do we have to drink there?
Oh, this would be orange pop, lots of sugar, wake me up for the day.
Great. Do you plan on going anywhere for spring break or doing anything?
Florida.
Florida. Ooh. Just Walt Disney World. Man, what's band doing in Florida?
Competing.
Everybody top in the nation or just the USA?
Just the USA.
Oh, any predictions for baseball this year?
Yeah, we're going to go down state, I figure.
What position are you?
Center field.
Center field. And who are the captains this year?
Me and Brad Zick, our shortstop.
Sweet.
We should be good, though.
When's your first game?
Hey.
Do you have a name for that big fish, or?
Oh, the big fish's name. No, we don't have a name for it. It's just called Big Fish.
Big Fish.
He stays in that little place all by, like...
Oh, no, he's got some friends.
Does he eat those
friends? Does he eat the friends?
Well, not all of them.
Do you have any embarrassing moments here at Downer South that you would like to share with the senior class?
Junior year, I was going to my gym class. I think it was second semester, too. And I was going to the locker room, and I walked into the guy's locker room instead of the girl's locker room. And there was a whole bunch of guys sitting there, and they're like, what are you doing in here? And I was like... And I felt really dumb, so I said I was looking for the teacher.
Lockport's number one in the state, aren't they?
Yeah, they're all right. We're still going to whoop them.
Yeah, we better. What position do you play, Brent?
I play left field, sir.
She's
a. I'm the team cheerleader.
She's the baseball cheerleader.
Yeah. Wow, that's new.
If you were to pick one favorite teacher here at DGS, who would that be and why?
I would have to say Mrs. Cedarblad, because she's... always really cool with everybody, and she's taught me probably more than any other English teacher, and she's like talks to everybody.
She has more Doc Martens than anyone can imagine.
Yeah, that's the main reason, Jessica.
If you had a favorite teacher at DGS, who would it be and explain why?
Probably Miss Lynn, just because she's been really cool to me. She like let me watch her house and stuff, so.
How did the musical go this year?
Well, what do you think, Jessica? You were in it.
How about I ask it? How do you think the musical went this year?
Well, Jessica and I think it went well, and everybody had a great time after we got over the fact that it's a lot of work, and you really have to work as a team, and I think we did that.
If you had a favorite teacher to pick from DGS,
Ms. Van Zandt.
Second,
Dr. A.
Why would that be?
Dr. A,
because both of them can teach without intimidating you, without making you feel lesser than you actually are. They can make you feel like you're something.
Are you going to prom?
Yeah.
Okay, are you gonna have a good time?
Yeah.
Are you gonna be in school tomorrow?
No.
Are you gonna be in school Monday?
Yeah.
And where are you going to college next year, Karen?
University of Wisconsin-Whitewater.
All right, sounds good. And what's their mascot?
The Warhawk.
The Warhawk, okay. Hey, that sounds good.
Yeah.
So do you have any messages for the graduating class of 98?
No.
No?
So you gotta remember one experience at your high school.
Embarrassing would be more better for us.
But you get to share with the camera.
Cross-country practice, early morning, sophomore year. We had a swimming practice, and I forgot underwear.
Oh, no.
I had to go home, and they made a nice scene of it at the banquet, yeah.
How's the volleyball team looking for this year?
Volleyball's looking good, Jay.
We're 1-0 right now. We got a big tournament this weekend.
Where's the tournament at?
Marist.
Marist. All right. Who are the captains this year for the volleyball team?
Steve Cagonese and myself.
Oh, what leadership there.
Leadership.
Stuff like that.
The zoo's open now. What? I just got 2 free tickets for Monday. You may maybe see at the zoo.
Nah.
No? Dolphin show is a real killer, though.
You see me in the zoo right now, man. What's the matter with you?
Ooh. Oh, I say you're referring to the school as a zoo.
Wow.
Yes?
Yeah.
Johnny, what are your plans after graduation?
I don't know, get a job, work full time.
Yeah, what do you see yourself in about 10 years?
Drafting, like architecture.
Wow, that's pretty impressive. Are you planning on being a writer in your future?
Yeah, I plan to major in journalism in college.
Oh really, where are you going to school?
Bradley University.
Nice.
Wow.
Stop now. Okay, hi, how you doing?
Fine.
What happened to your foot there, leg?
I sprained my ankle playing basketball.
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh my God. So Tyler, what class is this?
Advanced weight training.
So can you flex your muscles for the camera? Wow, yeah.
See?
My most embarrassing moment was as a freshman going to the pep assemblies and being told to go home over and over again.
My most embarrassing moment had to be freshman year on the basketball team when after practice we were putting the ball racks away and I fell over the ball rack. We picked up all the balls and then it turned again and I fell over it again and everyone had to pick it up again.
I think our class is pretty indifferent, kind of. Like I haven't noticed too much gossip when people hit the senior year and too much name calling or pointing. I mean, people just let them be who they are.
My most embarrassing moment was sitting in Psychology 2 with Ms. Vinzan in room 202, just eighth period of the afternoon, everything's kind of calm, we're just talking, and all of a sudden I let out this huge burp, and like, I don't burp. I just don't do things like that. And the whole class just cracked up laughing. I was so embarrassed.
The thing I'll miss most about Down to Grow South is hanging out with my friends, cheerleading, football games, and seventh hour guidance with Ms. Cozzo and our interesting conversations.
The senior class, in one sentence, I would probably have to say ready to go, because I don't know, it seems that like everyone has been through a lot here, and I don't know, like through the course of my 4 years, I've noticed the changes in myself, and I've seen a lot of other people change in a bunch of different ways. And I don't know, it just seems the people here now in the senior class are just kind of ready to go out and to move on and just kind of like make something of what they are now.
So what's your most fond experience about the seniors this year?
Well, I enjoyed all the kids. This is my first year, so it was kind of a freshman year for me, and it was really nice. I mean, the kids are very congenial, and we had a good time, even though I only spent a few minutes with them.
So, congenial, that would be...
I have no idea.
I think we better go look it up. Congenial.
Congenial, agreeable, suitable, or pleasing in nature or character. Suited or adapted in spirit, feeling, temper, etc. Compatible.
Compatible?
So in other words, we were just called compatible. What are you picking up?
It's not looking good. You know, in all reality, my tricorder says that I should be beamed out of here because there's no intelligent life left, particularly after June 5th.
Okay, do you have a lot of seniors in your classes?
Yes, in my Spanish 4 classes, mostly seniors.
So what do you think about them this year?
I
think they're ready to leave at this point of the year, actually. And they've done a good job in my class, anyway.
Oh, what are you composing, Chris?
Music.
What kind of music?
Music? I don't know. Like piano music?
Do you want to take the headphones off for this interview?
Yeah, like
the senior class, especially all the senior girls, we're wondering if you could show us your most prized possession, your pride and joy.
Oh, yes, I happen to have it with me.
Great.
I lost it for about 6 months.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, no.
There it is.
Oh. I get a good glimpse of that.
And then do you have the picture that your brother gave you? The one where you're running around in the field?
Oh, yes, I have that too.
Now, Mr. Garrels, he's a collector of fine arts. So we're going to show you the nice picture that he carries around with him every day.
This is where they caught me in the football field here.
Oh, God. Oh, that's... So you've substituted for the senior class many times. Can you tell us some of your fondest memories of the senior class this year?
Well, all of my memories are fond memories. Whenever I'm with those wonderful people, that's where I love to be.
Would you call us congenial?
Call you what?
Congenial.
I call you wonderful human beings.
We're about to having connections today. That must mean that we're...
I know, we are.
Congenial?
We're congenial.
We're about to enter.
Who wants shotgun? Can I have shotgun?
You can get shotgun. Ooh. Oh, we're getting caught.
Okay, just turn the car on, put it in drive. What exactly are we looking for? Do you think that Charlene and I and the senior class are congenial?
Oh, I think you're very congenial. Outgoing, probably the top 10% of congeniality in a survey, I would say. I'd be 95% confident with that.
If it was one piece of advice to give seniors, what would that be?
Oh, I guess probably just enjoy everything that they do. You know, it's so hard to decide what you want to do now. But whatever decisions you make and however... you know, whatever you do for the next couple of years or the rest of your life, that's just to enjoy it and really have a good time.
If there's any advice that you want to give to the senior class, what would it be?
I say have as good of a summer as you can, because this is your best, I mean, this is a great summer. I'm not going to say it's the best summer of your life, but this will be a great summer.
Everybody, you want to see my imitation of a duck?
Yeah! Yeah!
Of course.
Woo!
But more seriously, I just love the class of 98, and I want you to take care of yourselves and keep yourselves safe. So please, please don't drink and drive. Be good to yourselves, because I love you. Go class of 98!
I got a blue and red Adidas bag and a humongous binder. I'm trying my best not to look like a minor niner. When I'm for the football team to prove that I'm a man, I guess I shouldn't tell them that I like Duran Duran. This is me in grade 9, baby. This is me in grade 9. This is me in grade 9, baby. This is me in grade 9. If I had $1 million.
If I had $1 million.
Well, I'd buy you a house.
Well, I would buy you a house.
And if I had $1 million.
Well, if I had $1 million.
Buy you furniture for your house.
And maybe a nice Chesterfield or an ottoman.
And if I had $1 million.
Well, if I had $1 million.
Well, I'd buy you a K-car.
A nice, reliable automobile.
But if I had $1 million.
others.